अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मोहम्मद अमजिद, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड साइकोलॉजी, कोहाट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। आई एम योर इंस्ट्रक्टर फॉर द कोर्स थ्योरीज ऑफ पर्सनैलिटी। आई वेलकम यू टू लेक्चर नंबर 10 ऑफ योर कोर्स। इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ एल्फ्रेड एडलर्स थ्योरी ऑफ पर्सनैलिटी। Let's start our lesson. Look at the contents which we are going to discuss in our today's lecture. We will discuss birth order. We will also discuss Adlerian psychotherapy. And then we will talk about critical evaluation. And at last, we will discuss how did Adler disagree with Sigmund Freud. Now we will discuss birth order, which is one of the important concepts of Adler's theory. According to Adler, birth order refers to the order in which the children of a family were born. According to Adler, birth order had a significant and predictable impact on a child's personality. Now we will discuss what Alfred Adler said about firstborn child. According to Alfred Adler, firstborn children have inherent advantage due to their parents recognizing them as the larger, the stronger, and the older. This gives firstborn children the traits of a guardian of law and order. These children have a high amount of personal power and they value the concept of power with reverence. Now we will discuss that what Alfred Adler said about second born child. According to Alfred Adler, second-born children are constantly in the shadow of their older siblings. They are incessantly striving for superiority under pressure, driven by the existence of their older, more powerful siblings. According to Alfred Adler, if the second born is encouraged and supported, he will be able to attain power as well, and he and the first born will work together. Now we will discuss what Alfred Adler said about youngest child. Adler said that youngest children operate in a constant state of inferiority. They are constantly trying to prove themselves due to their perception of inferiority relative to the rest of their family. According to Adler, there are two types of youngest children. The most successful type excels every other member of the family and becomes the family's most capable member. Another more unfortunate type of youngest child does not excel because he lacks the necessary self-confidence. this child becomes evasive and avoidant towards the rest of the family. Now we will discuss what Adler said about only child. Only children, according to Adler, are also an unfortunate case. Due to their being the sole object of their parents' attention, the only child becomes dependent to high degree, waits constantly for someone to show him the way, and searches for support at all times. They also come to see the world as a hostile place due to their parents' constant vigilance. Now we will discuss Adlerian psychotherapy. The following section is a summary of the 6 stages of Adlerian psychotherapy, which was developed by Stein and Edward in 2002. These stages serve as a guide, since every individual's journey will have a slightly different path. According to Adler, just as one cannot find 2 leaves of a tree absolutely identical, so one cannot find 2 human beings absolutely alike. Since in Adlerian psychology, the goal is for the patient to feel competent and connected. The overall goal of Adlerian psychotherapy is to help the patient to overcome feelings of inferiority. This process has 3 sub-goals. The first sub-goal of this process is to reduce the inferiority complex of exaggerated feelings of inferiority to a normal and helpful size, where the patient strives to significance but not overridden. The second sub-goal of this process is to reduce and banish the superiority complex of constant striving for superiority over others. And third sub-goal of this process is to promote feelings of community and equality. Now we will discuss phase 1, establishing the therapeutic relationship. For the psychotherapy to be effective, it is essential that the therapist and the client commence with a healthy working relationship. There must be a warm, empathetic bond which opens the door for gradual process. This bond is created by genuine warmth and compassion expressed by the therapist, in addition to the trust of the client in the relationship. Now we will discuss phase 2, which is assessment. The therapist must conduct a thorough assessment of the client in order to develop an effective therapeutic process. The analysis must identify at least the following elements. What are those elements? The first one is feelings of inferiority. The second one is fictive goals, defined as an imagined compensatory self-ideal created to inspire permanent and total relief in the future from the primary inferiority feelings. And the third one is psychological movement, defined as the thinking, feeling, and behavioral motion of a person makes in response to a situation or task. The third phase is encouragement and clarification. The process of encouraging the client helps them reduce feelings of inferiority. The therapist can start by acknowledging courage that the client has already shown and continue by discussing small steps the client can take towards getting to a more confident place. For instance, if the client has a limited radius of activity, the client and the therapist might discuss ways to broaden their activity. The second crucial aspect of this phase is to clarify the client's core feelings and beliefs regarding the self, others, and life in general. This is done by using Socratic questioning. Through this method, the therapist challenges the client's private logic and focuses on psychological movement around his fictive goals. Now we will discuss phase 4, interpretation. Once the therapy has reached the point where the client has made some progress, client and the therapist have examined the meaning of his movement in relation to his goal. The therapy is ready to begin interpreting the client's style of life. This must only be done when the client is encouraged sufficiently, and this must be done with significant care. Discussing and recognizing topics such as inferiority complex can be difficult for the client, but new insight can be transformative. Now we will discuss phase 5, which is style of life redirection. Now the client and the therapist have recognized the issue with the client's style of life. The task becomes to redirect the style of life towards life satisfaction. This involves reducing and productively
utilizing feelings of inferiority, changing the fictive final goal, and increasing feeling of community. This is accomplished using different methods depending on the specific need of the client. Now we will discuss final phase, which is phase 6, meta therapy. Finally, some clients may wish to seek further personal development towards higher values such as truth, beauty, and justice. Towards this end, the therapist can provide stimulation for the client to become the best version of himself. This process is certainly challenging and requires a deep understanding of individual client. Let's talk about critical evaluation. Adler focuses on wholeness or holistic existence of humans. According to Adler, personality is creative self, which allows us to be what we choose to be. His theory is used by counselors, therapists, and educators. Now we will discuss how did Adler disagree with Sigmund Freud. He disagreed with Sigmund Freud on number of issues. According to Sigmund Freud, behavior is motivated by internal biological drives, sex and aggression. For Adler, behavior is motivated by social influence and striving for superiority. Then Sigmund Freud argued that people have not choice in shaping their personality. For Adler, people are responsible for what they are. Sigmund Freud said that present behavior is caused by the past, our childhood. According to Adler, present behavior is shaped by the future and it is goal-oriented. Sigmund Freud emphasizes on unconscious process. And Adler said that people are aware, they are in their conscious sense of what they are doing and why. Freud split the personality into components like id, ego, superego. Adler thought the individual should be studied as a whole. He used holistic approach. For Sigmund Freud, relationship, the same-sex parent is of primary importance. For Adler, wider family relationships, including with siblings, of primary importance. These are the references. Students, it's all about for our today's lecture. I hope you will read it and understand it. थैंक यू वेरी मच, अल्लाह हाफिज़।